Great. So today's topic is video marketing, and this is something I've actually found quite fun to do in online teaching. It does take a bit of time, because if you are promoting your own business, you do have to do the marketing side of it. Unless you can hire someone, then you're really lucky. But we are just teachers at the end of the day. We're not marketers, unless you've worked in marketing. I'm going to go through some of the things that I've kind of put in place with my marketing, and particularly with video marketing. So I'm sure most of us are familiar with social media and clicking on something and seeing a reel or a video, and it's very captivating. Most of the time, it grabs your attention, and there's a nice song or tune that you like, and it's sometimes better to watch or more captivating than a poster or a flyer or something. So can be very powerful in advertising. Okay, so let's begin. So the main topic today is video marketing, not necessarily video making, although I will touch on that, but I'm not a videographer, so I can't give you all the advice about how to make the best video. But we will touch on the kind of content we're going to look for when we make a video. So given we are online teachers, having content is very important. So maybe we can all write in the chat or say out loud what you think the best content to use in your marketing video. What you think the best content to use is.
Curriculum.
The topics, and break it down. So for example, if someone's following you, it's that each, for example, every Monday you're going to come live or something, and what topic can have, so you tell them in advance, I don't know, something like that.
Yes, the topic that you will be teaching, if you're doing a short course, or the topics you teach in the book that you teach in, that's very good, yes. Christine said comprehension techniques to improve exam performance. If that's your target, yes. Remember, we're online teachers. We're using platforms like Zoom or Voov. Anyone else got anything? So obviously there's endless content when it comes to education. That's how I see it, because as a teacher, it feels like every day you're learning something new and learning a new way to teach a topic, and all learners are different. But one thing that is really powerful about online teaching is you have your lessons if you record them. So you have that content, and you can use that in your videos. You can show what you do in your lessons, and that's very powerful. Then you also have yourself, so speaking, introducing yourself, introducing what you teach. People can get to know your face, your expressions, the way you use your hands and your voice. For me, I have a South African accent, so I sometimes avoid that if I feel like I just want to focus on my content and what I teach. although a lot of recruiters and parents contact me just because of the videos of me introducing myself. So it is a really cool thing that you can do in online teaching. You can reach a lot of people through social media. Okay. So there's different kinds of videos we can make. I'm sure we've all played around with this. What kinds of videos can you make and put out there of your teaching?
Like snippets of your lessons?
Snippets of your lessons. Okay, so that would be your content mainly. That wouldn't really be of yourself. Snippets of your lessons, that's really good. Teaching vocabulary with images or videos. That's what Christine says. Yes, with images. So if you have an image, maybe a screenshot from a video, a lesson you've taught, you can show that in your marketing video. Okay. Sometimes I even take screenshots of my lessons and I put them on a flyer. Teaching Koala Go, so I do clips of the classroom. Amazing, yes. And it's really cool in Koala Go. This is pretty, it's quite interactive and it's pretty to see. Yeah, so I found you can get long videos of introductions of yourself. So you can actually do a video just on you. Sometimes parents want to know what your experience is, what you like to do in your spare time, the kind of person you are, your background, what your work you've done before. So even just a video on your experience, and you can put pictures of maybe a classroom that you worked in or a country that you worked in, the schools you worked in, also really cool. And then you can also, if you have children, you can introduce your children. And those videos might be a little bit longer, so you maybe don't want to put that on social media. But if a parent contacts you and wants to know more about you, you can send them that video. And then you can also do a combination. So a shorter video of who you are, what you teach, your experience, your background, and then more on the content of what you teach, and maybe go through a kind of lesson that you would do. Christine says vocal terms, example, onomatopoeia, example, bang. Yeah, so you could actually do examples of what you teach in a video. There's so much, it's endless. And then you can just focus on what you teach. You don't have to be in the video. Your face doesn't have to be there. You don't even have to have a recording with your voice. It can just be content. Okay. So I will basically today, we'll go through some videos that I've created in my time as an online teacher. And I just want to touch a bit on the software. So if you have Apple, there's a free software called iMovie. You can edit videos in iMovie. You can change audios. You can get access to songs or background music. You can snip a video, so you can trim it, make it shorter. You can split it. You can do a lot with that program. So that's the one I use. If you don't have Apple, for Android, I know the equivalent is Filmora, and I have not used Filmora, but from what I've researched, it's quite similar to iMovie. And then if you want to get quite technical about your editing, there's DaVinci Resolve, and that one is free, but it is intensive. It's quite a heavy program if you're going to have it on your computer. You might want to have a faster computer for that. And then there's also this one, which is an online video editing app. The free version has a watermark. So that's something iMovie doesn't have. You don't get a watermark of the video editing software. But that sometimes isn't really a big deal. InShot is also quite simple to use. That's for your phone. So you can't get that on PC, from what I know. I've tried to download it before. And then other apps that are cool to use, Zoom or Vuv. If you record yourself or your lesson, then save that. So you have that all on a folder in your computer. So what I usually do is I keep all my recorded lessons, which is all my lessons, in a folder on my computer. And then after like 6 months, I go through them and I see which ones are one to keep for marketing and which ones I want to just delete because I won't use again. I know a lot of people use their cloud to store that, and that is also really important. You can do that as well. I've done that before, where I've stored important lessons on a cloud. The only thing is, it's so difficult to store all your lessons if you've been teaching for like 2 years. You know, it's a lot of memory. So I just keep the ones up to 6 months that I think are important, and then keep that under like a marketing folder on my computer. Okay, and then PowerPoint's also really cool. It has So using Zoom and PowerPoint together, I'll show you a video in which you can create where you go through your content, but you also have a picture of yourself speaking. And then also I want to talk a bit about Canva. So you can access premium apparently through, if you teach at an online school, in Canva, you can, I'll show you, let me actually go into Canva. So I haven't tried this because I don't work for an online school, but if you are interested, and I think I want to try this, you can go here under education, and get verified, and then you can get access to, if you can prove that you work for a school, I think you have to upload your qualification. So your name, your surname, your school name, the address, the school website. And then I think after you say continue, the next thing is you upload a document of your certificate or contract with the school. And then you can apparently get access. I don't know if Sandy is here. Is Sandy here? Let me check. Okay, I don't see Sandy, but Sandy did this, and she did this successfully. And I'll tell you why in a second, why this is important. Obviously, it's fun to use Canva for flyers, but with video editing, you can use the free version, but there's a cool thing you can do with the premium when you make videos. It has a video, so there's an AI video editor, which is really cool. Najina said that she worked for an online teaching company, but they did not accept the contract. So Najina, did you try the premium option on Canva?
Yeah, I tried the premium option, but I worked for an online teaching company in England. So they give me a contract. There's no website.
Oh, there's no website. Oh, so that you couldn't.
Yeah, so they didn't accept my contract, even though I had one. And then I went back to the company and they tried to help me, but it didn't get accepted.
I wonder if you could even contact Canva regarding that. Yeah. I'm going to speak to Sandy. I'll speak to Sandy about that, because maybe there's a way in which, if your school doesn't have a website, you could still get access.
It's going to help if they have.
Okay, so the reason why I say that is because if you do have premium, so this is nice, you can use the Magic Studio, which helps you create a video, which is really nice, quite quickly. So this is if you don't want to spend too much time making a video and you just want to create a short video on one kind of topic and you just want to put it out there on Facebook as a reel, because it's a really nice way to make a reel. So let's say I want to just do a video on chemistry, preparing learners for, so it's, you just select some images. You can also select videos and you just type at the bottom what you want to promote, video to promote a chemistry lesson. To prepare a student for an exam. Let's see if it accepts that. So this is an AR thing. It generates a short video for you, very quick. And I think there's even music. There we go. All right, so I've just uploaded 3 pictures. And yeah, I've got a 9-second video. Very nice for social media. Just make sure I've got my... Okay. So it's very quick, 9 seconds, but I just want to quickly do a quick video for social media, but I don't want to spend too much time on it. So that's the cool thing about this. And you can also change this to a different language depending on the student you're advertising to. There we go. There's a translate. Yeah, you can translate it to whatever language you need. So that's very cool. But if you don't have premium, it's fine. There are other ways to make videos and it doesn't take too long. But it does depend on how in depth and how detailed and how pretty you want your video. Yeah, it is very easy. So you can't do this AR thing with a free account, but you can still make videos with Canva. So I'll show you. If you just go onto your Canva page and you go to video, so this is not a free account. There's a whole bunch of templates, and Canva's so nice for if you want to make more content-driven videos. Okay, because there's so many pretty like fonts and cool, just really nice ways, like formats that you don't have to really think about. You just need to upload your video onto that. So this one, I actually created a video using this format. And this is the start of the video. But I wanted to put there, do you want to learn science with Carrie? Okay. And then the next thing I did was I uploaded my own video. So you can upload videos into Canva, not only images, but that's where, you know, you can put your textbooks that you want to use. And like we said earlier, that's your textbooks. Videos, you can upload something from a lesson. This is a short clip of me teaching chemistry. I've actually made this really quick, so you can see it's fast. And that I did in another editing software. Okay. As far as I'm concerned, I think you can change the speed here. But I would say if you want to include a lot of content in a video, do multiple videos of what you teach, or make a video times 8 or times 20 speed, so that the audience can see all that you do in like your lesson. You want to fit as much content as you can. So I always speed up my videos. Okay. I just want to admit. Okay, so you can see it's very, very fast. Okay, so that's just a video of me teaching chemistry a concept. So what I could do is then I could just put some text at the bottom. You can add some text. So this is where Canva is really nice. I can add a text and I can say, learn about different materials, or learn about the periodic table. Okay, so that's where it's really nice. And then for English, you can make it more subject to English. Tatiana asked, how much is premium? I actually don't know. I don't have a premium account. So yeah, I can't say. Like
it's
I said,
$10.99 a month, I think.
$10.99 or
I'm in the UK, it's in pounds. I don't know what it is in dollars.
Okay. Thank you. So basically you can make that magic design, but you can't download it if you don't have premium. So I think try get the educators premium first before buying a subscription. But also, like I said, you can edit videos and make videos that are short on your own and download them not using premium. You just don't have access to all the premium options. So anything with that crown or that diamond, you can't use. Okay, so we will go back to Canva if we have time in the questions, but I want to just show some videos that I have made. We'll go through each video And then I want to kind of ask you what you think the focus is or the kind of video it is and what the main content I'm trying to push. And then I'll also talk a little bit about the process and how I made the video. Okay. One thing that's important is if you're going to market your video to social media, keep it short. I know that on TikTok, videos are generally 15 seconds long. So try not make your video more than 15 seconds if you want someone to click on it and see it. Okay. You can make a longer video introducing your course and then make that detailed. And then when you get someone to contact you, someone's contacted you after seeing a short clip, then you can send them the long video. Okay. And then also music is really nice. So having music play in the background to a video is always good. Even if you are speaking, having music play softly and nice music. So like happy, childlike music. Okay. All right, so I'm going to start and then we can do Q&A. We will get time for Q&A. Okay, so this is just an introduction video. I'm just introducing myself, who I am, where I'm from, how long I've been teaching. Cool.
Hi, I am Carrie Cross. And I am an online teacher, and I've been teaching for 4 years. I thought I would share a little bit about myself before we begin learning together. I have worked as a teacher for 4 years, teaching maths and science online. I have worked also as an oceanographer, and my favorite part about science is going on adventures. Especially open ocean adventures. Yes, I did participate in a science trip to Antarctica, and it was very cold. I also enjoy doing chemistry experiments, fun ones, messy ones. I love adventures and having fun. I live in Durban, South Africa, with my mom and nephew, who also loves science experiments. We enjoy reading SpongeBob comics together and laughing and being goofy. I did study in Cape Town, and when I was there, I did lots of diving, but now I am a surfer. Turns out I'm passionate about the ocean and love learning and teaching all the fascinating things about it. My favorite sea creature at the moment is a sea turtle. I feel so privileged to wake up every morning and see the sunrise while being in the ocean. I love being in the water, but if I don't see you in the water, I hope to see you in class.
Okay, so I don't know if anyone can guess what kind of video that was or the type of content I was going for there.
You gave information about yourself, what you've done in the past, and you put your family picture in. So you're kind of building that confidence within the person who's watching the video.
Yes. So it's just introducing myself. You can see it's quite a lengthy video about my experience, where I've worked, what I've done in the past. So I'm building, like you said, that that confidence that I've worked with kids, I've lived with a child. I know. thanks, Alison said introduction video. Yeah. So it's not even about really what I teach. I only go into that a little bit in the beginning. So if you have parents who this is really important to them, that they are they're with someone who has experience, that has a family, has hobbies, has interests, and has that in their life, then this kind of video would be good to share with them. Okay, and you do get parents like that. All right, and then this video, it's quite a short one, and you can see InShot. InShot I made on the phone. So that's why it looks like this. This was actually one of my first videos.
Hi, my name is Kerry. I am a maths and science tutor, and you can call me Teacher Kerry. I have been teaching for 4 years. I have my bachelor in science and a PGCE teaching degree. I am also qualified to teach English as a second language, and I hope to see you in class.
Okay, so very short. And as you can see, I'm the main focus. You can see my face, you can see my expression. That's very much just you and what you teach, and very quick. Okay, so you could put that on social media. Christine, do you have a question?
Oh, I just wanted to say, I just think it shows that you're sort of relatable, engaging, credible, interesting, and warm and friendly. And that's all to your credit. It's a good selling tool, isn't it?
Yes, it is a good selling tool. Are you talking about this video or the previous video?
Well, this one is a good example, and the previous one.
Mm. You can hear I'm also speaking slowly, because I'm kind of appealing to learners who don't speak English as a first language. Okay. Does anyone have any questions before we move on? Oh yeah, Tatiana said, do you need to get written permission from your students to use video clips of lessons in which they are present? Yes, I have asked parents if I can use them, and I've blocked out their faces. So I've just put an emoji by their face, and most parents have been fine with it. And Christine, did you have another question?
No, I just think it's got such huge potential, hasn't it, to reach out.
It does. You're right. It really does. So you can get quite creative with your content, and that's why it's good to always keep your lessons and keep even memories and photos of things that can add to your personal, like your personal story of who you are as a teacher. So like my diving pictures, I use that a lot because I teach science. And who wouldn't want a teacher who's actually experienced, you know, ecosystems and oceans, and they love nature. Like I'm practicing what I preach, you know, and I think that's also important. So, and I know most, like some teachers who have children will include their children in their videos, and that's also really nice.
Hi.
Okay, so this one is the next video. This is a bit of introduction of me, but also content. So at some point a year and a half ago, I was teaching English reading, reading adventures and reading explorers.
Hi, I am Teacher Kerry, and I am a qualified English teacher. Do you want to go on an adventure? In this course, we will be learning about erupting mountains, to the first Olympics, to what it's like to grow up in a family in Gabon. This is Reading Adventures. In this course, we will do some audios and discussions to develop your speaking skills. We will watch some videos, and we will do reading comprehensions and target language practice. I also have free resources, some links and articles, very fun games and worksheets. So I really hope to see you on this adventure. Bye.
Okay. So what kind of video was that one? Does anyone want to say? Okay, so Alison says curriculum. Yes. So this is curriculum. And you can see at the end, I included some free resources. So I've got pictures of the resources that I'm going to use in this course, or extra worksheets. And most of it is translated. So I teach to Chinese learners. So I always want to translate. Even though I'm speaking, I'm saying we're doing reading adventures, I will write in Chinese. These are the textbooks. Christine, what techniques do you use? I think for those books, there were reading comprehensions in the book. So I followed that and the teaching guides. Okay.
So sorry, which book did you use?
It was Reading Adventures, very similar to Reading Explorer. I think it was a series before.
Okay, thank you.
Pleasure. Okay, and then this is, okay, here's another video. Let's watch it and then we can talk.
Hello everyone, I'm Teacher Kerry and I am passionate about learning and teaching science. I have an honours degree in ocean science and I teach chemistry, biology, physics and geography. So if any of those subjects interest you, please book a class and hopefully I'll see you.
Okay, so you can see they're all very different, these videos. But I actually just want to go through the process in which I made that one, because you can see my background has, it's like a Zoom background. So I created that Zoom background in Canva and recorded myself in Zoom. So that whole video was me in Zoom. And then I took my flyer and just put it in the front of the video. So this was made using iMovie. So I would just put my flyer in the beginning and my flyer at the end. So if you want them to see your email address or your website, you could put that at the end. So you can see this is just made in Zoom. My background using a Zoom background, and I recorded it. And there we go. That's just me speaking. Alison says, I noticed you like the easygoing music. That also tells a lot about your personality and probably your teaching style. Yes, that's another way you can promote your teaching style. You're right, through your music that you use. And I definitely am more easygoing, that more easygoing approach. Okay, so this one again, I start off with a Zoom background that I've found and recorded all of this in Zoom. So me with my face speaking, that's in Zoom. And then the content that I create after this is from Canva. So I've uploaded a video of myself talking onto Canva. And then I've overlaid it with some pictures and then also another video. Okay, so let's see. Hello, learners and parents. I am Teacher Kerry. I am passionate about teaching science to G3 to G. Do you want to join my science class? Well, if you enjoy science, this class is for you. We will learn exciting curriculum and do some... So I'm just using PowerPoint in Zoom while I'm recording. So I've created a PowerPoint of what I want to show them in my video. And you can see me in the corner there. In Zoom. Challenging and interesting problems. We'll also practice our speaking. There's writing activities and drawing opportunities as well. So this is all in PowerPoint. I will provide the books, the textbooks, and there will definitely be homework. Let's see this fun experiment. If you can find out what is going on, what scientific phenomena is happening, maybe you will enjoy my class. Watch carefully. Ooh, very colorful, very exciting. I wonder what scientific phenomena is happening here. Ooh. So if you teach in English, you could do something similar to this where you go through an exercise in your video, explaining a concept or explaining a worksheet. But in this case, I didn't need to get any permission because it was just me doing this experiment. So you could do that where you don't need permission. You just record yourself going through a worksheet, sharing your screen, maybe even asking questions to the audience. And then you don't, you just use PowerPoint and you have yourself in the corner, or you share your screen. Okay, so I'm just going to admit someone. Every now and again, someone joins. Okay, welcome. Okay, I'm just going to play the rest of the video. If you could guess, maybe you will enjoy my class. So if these kinds of facts and fun information excite you, you can contact. So yeah, you can put your website or your QR code, you could put your Facebook account or whatever, wherever you want someone to kind of reach you, even your email address, if you're comfortable with that. Me or join my science group for fun facts. Hope to see you. Okay, so like I said, different kinds of videos. You can have just of you, you can have you and your content. And this is a nice one because it's me, it's what I teach, my content, and even just the practical tasks that we do in my
lessons. Hello, learners.
Okay. All right. Now, I did show you in Canva, there's these cool, kind of formats with beautiful pictures, and you can take a video and you can edit it and make it your own. So this was made in Canva. Okay, there I'm going through a lesson. This is a recorded lesson and it's sped up, and I've taken parts of the lesson, not the full lesson, but just parts of it where I'm going through vocabulary. And I've put a little note here at the bottom what we are doing. So we are learning keywords, vocab, and we are doing writing. Then we go through the book. And here we're playing some games. These are fun games for the kids, also educational. And then I'll put that down there. So I'm making a note of what we're doing. But notice this, I'm not talking at all in this video. Also, something I didn't do in this last video, this is science with one of my older kids. We are learning about the periodic table, and it's important to just turn off your sound. So if you've done a recording and you use in an editing software, turn the sound off, because here I didn't, and you can hear it sped up, and you can hear our talking is squeaky because of this, the 20 times speed. Okay, so that's mainly content. You can see I've posted some videos of my lessons in that video. And I saw, Alison, you asked about music. So that did come with Canva, and that isn't the free the free Canva. So you do get free music in Canva. Through that, through the making a video option. Okay, so I'm gonna go through my last video, and then we can have a time of questions and we can just go through a bit of the process of making the video and maybe look at Canva a bit more. This video was also, I'm not speaking, it's just content. The initial page just says, let's start the new year with a free trial class. And that's, so that's what that means. Okay. Oh yeah, also if your video is from a lesson and you don't want to show the student, or the student doesn't want to be in the video, but they're fine with the video being shown, like the actual lesson content, you can crop them out. So this was a biology lesson, but I don't have myself there or my student. This is cropped out. So these really cool, like the sound, so the audio, those, that laptop image with the emojis, and the background, that is all Canva. So all the pretty things that you see, even the emoji that I put on, that's Canva. And that's the free version of Canva. Okay, there I didn't put my WeChat group. I didn't put my QR code. Just said book a class. And yeah, it's just a fun video with lots of content. So that is content specific, just my lessons, what we would do in class, and the textbooks we use. So I did show textbooks in the beginning of the video. But it's very quick. This whole video is 35 seconds. I mean, that's quite long already. But I'm not doing like a 2 minute, 1 minute video. This is short enough. I just don't know if this was short enough. It might have been too long. This one got, I got a lot of feedback of this one. This one is, oh, it's 1 minute. Yeah. So I can't say what the best is, but I'd say keep it short. I would even say keep it under 1 minute. If you can. Yeah. So I try to keep this one as short as possible. Yeah. And then if you're doing lots of posts and quick posts on Facebook, like in your reels, you can do those very short videos, like 15 seconds, to get people to go to your Facebook page. And then you can have these longer videos. Okay. All right, so I know that the main message today was about the content, your marketing, actually like what you want to put in a video and not the process of making a video. But we've got some time, so I'm going to do some Q&A. Yeah, Tatiana?
Hi, I just wanted to make sure this presentation, this class will be loaded to the masterclass, correct? The master course?
I think so. I'm sure it will. I'll speak to Jess. I actually don't know. Let me speak to Jess about that. Okay. And I'll just tell her if she can load it to the master class.
Great. Thank you so much. Yeah. By the way, this was a great presentation.
Thank you. I'm glad. I hope it was helpful. Yes, Najina.
Hiya, I just wanted to know on Canva, you said that you did that emoji. How do you do that when you create a video?
So when you create a video on Canva, let me share. OK, Okay, so this was, let's go back to the start. We go to home. And we go to video. So create a blank. And then Canva will have templates that you can use. And you obviously can only use the free ones, which are still really nice. This one is free. Okay, now if I decide this video here, I don't want to show that video. I want to show my own video. So I delete that, delete video. Now under uploads, I can put my own video in there. So I want to put my lesson in there. Okay. Now my lesson's there. Let's say my student's face is in the corner. All I do is I go to an emoji under elements. So I'm looking for a picture, or I'm looking for an icon, I'm looking for an emoji. I choose a free one and it goes there, make it, and then I just cover face. If I want to make this look sciencey, science tutorial, I can put science, earth, and I can get some pictures of the earth. Okay. If I don't like this font, I can change the font. And that's just that. So let's see. Okay, so I should have put this emoji down here under my student's face. And then what you can do is you can actually decide when you want that emoji to come up. So yeah, click on that emoji and animate. Can pan in. And you can actually see the timing of that emoji when it comes in. Show timing. So that it does take some time to just play around with Canva. So now I don't want it in the beginning of the video. I just make it a bit towards the part where I don't want my student's face to be seen. Okay, so somewhere make it down there. Okay, so the first part of the video, you don't see that. And then boom. Okay, so now it's too short. It's coming in too short. I need to lengthen this time and maybe just make it a bit bigger. Okay, so you just need to play around with these kinds of videos. You can add another video in or another, basically like a slide, almost like a PowerPoint slide. And if you've used all the free content, yeah, you haven't used the pro content, you will be able to download this video under download. Okay. It seems like this video doesn't have sound. Let's see. No, it doesn't, but you can add sound. Let's see. Volume of all videos on pages. I remember adding sound. Just check. Definitely a way to add audio elements, audio. Okay, so here, let's see if you can access some that are free. I do remember using some free ones at some point. Free for 30 days, no. Okay, you might have to use your video editing software for that. You can't add audio. But that one with all the marine animals, that was a audio from Canva. That wasn't my own audio. So some videos do come with audios. And even the one with the Chinese New Year in the beginning, that one came with an audio. So let's see if I can find one. Okay. Let's go back to the questions. I don't want to spend too much time. Can you upload audio into Canva, Alison? Can I upload? That is a good question. Let's go to upload. Yeah, you can. Drag media here or upload connect an account. So yeah, if you've got an audio file that you've downloaded, like a Jack Johnson song that's instrumental, you can upload it here. Thank you, Carrie. Fantastic video and ideas. Have to leave now. Okay, bye, Fatima. Tatiana, do you know if it's possible to blur a face? I don't. I have not tried that, but I'm sure there's a way to do that through a video editing software. I'm not so sure about on Canva. I think it might be limited. Can't answer that one. Sorry, haven't figured that out. Okay, and then have another question for everyone. Yes, Tatiana, do you want to ask?
I'm wondering, at one of the classes we had recently, and you might know the answer to this, but maybe there's some of us regulars and they might remember. Somebody mentioned with the YouTube video, if you use the section of the URL that comes after the equals sign, then you can like use it and use excerpts from it. Does anybody remember that or from what class that was? So I can go back and no one remembers. Do you know about that, Carrie?
I don't. No? I don't.
All right.
Sorry. All right, thank you. I didn't know I wasn't there. Sorry. But Christine says, apart from using a piece of recorded Zoom, is there a resource which helps you put you speaking in a separate bubble on top of a text? Are these instructions?
I've noticed that Jess uses it for some of her her boot camps, and Katie Prescott uses it on their boot camps that you can just learn at your leisure from.
Do you know what it's called?
They just make a video on Canva, and then like your face comes up in a circle in the corner. Is that what you mean?
Well, I just don't know how you do it. So are you telling me, Emma, that there's a facility on Canva to do that?
Yeah, I've done it before. I could try and maybe send you screenshots or something later.
Okay, thank you very much.
Okay. That'll be very helpful. Okay, cool. So you can do that on Canva, where you have yourself recording, you record on Canva.
Yeah, and your face is like in a circle in the bottom.
That's cool. Would you need premium for that? The premium Canva?
I'm not sure. I am on premium, so I don't know whether you need it for it or not.
Okay, let me see if there's an option here. Presentation, maybe it's that one where you can present something almost like PowerPoint, but maybe you can record yourself speaking. Yeah, maybe it's under presentation. That would be good to look into, definitely, yeah, for making videos. Okay, awesome. Thanks, guys. I don't want to keep anyone a little bit longer. Cool. Does anyone have any questions, or are we cool to say goodbye?
Could I just also know if there are instructions on how to create videos on Canva so we can go back to them?
I haven't seen instructions on Canva. Maybe there are though, like if you look under, honestly, if you just Google like how to create a video in Canva or YouTube it. I just play around with the software. I don't really follow like an instruction unless I'm really lost.
Okay.
It's kind of just figure it out as you go. But we are teachers, we're not marketers. Like we can't expect to produce amazing quality unless we have someone who does it for us. Our main job is to teach. So that's why I don't spend too much time like on these things, because like, you know, you still have to like focus on your teaching. But it is fun to play around and kind of get it out there. And if you are able to hire someone to do your marketing, then like, I think like that's amazing. Awesome. Thanks everyone.
Cool. Thank you.
Hope to see you all soon and chat soon.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Please remember to ask Jess about loading it to the master course.
The main course. Okay, sure. We'll do. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
See you.